Hi, it's Adam Hewis, and I'm coming to you, as always, from the digital studios of Market Club, and we're looking at the S&P 500, something we've done before, but I think it's worthwhile looking at again because we're seeing a lot of things happening in the markets, some changes of directions. Obviously, we're in December, which is a very tricky month as the markets have become thinner and more volatile. But we're looking at the S&P 500, as I said, we're looking at the lows that were started in March of this year. And we had, obviously, the market was under pressure in most of 08, and we peaked out in 07. Now, these lines that you see here are Fibonacci lines, and this is a 61.8% retracement, and this is a 50% retracement. Now, we're at a level now where this market is having some difficulty. We are seeing prices have been going up steadily, like this, since around the March period, and we have seen this momentum on the MACD actually going the opposite way. So prices have been going up, and the momentum has been going down. So it's getting weaker and weaker in our estimation. So this is what I want to do. Let me take everything off the screen, and we're going to scope this in a little further, which is easy to do. Just click on the little magnifying built-in zoom here, and you can see where we are right now. Now, a couple of things are happening here. One is we have turned back down in the MACD line, which is right here. You see the market's come down below there, and this is starting to go down, showing weakness. And we have been going sort of, if you take this period right here, I'll just draw a little square, the market's been going sort of sideways, really hasn't had any real strong direction. And you're seeing some telltale signs. These are not good in Japanese candlestick terms. You're seeing some selling pressure coming in here, here, and here. You see, notice how the market had a move up and then but it fell back from right around this level. This 110 level has proven to be a really difficult level for this market, and I think we're going to see that come into play more and more. This is a key zone here. If we go below this level here, and I'll tell you the exact level, it's going to indicate that you should be out, at least if you're trading with our trade triangles, you should be out of this market. So let me just take this off the screen for now, and I'll show you what I mean by this. If we put our cursor over here, we can see the low here was 1,083.74, and that's the key level to look at this week in the S&P 500. If we go below that level, then it's going to turn our weekly trade triangle into a red weekly triangle, which means exit all long positions in the S&P 500. Now, paying close attention to this indicator, it's done very, very well in this market. So I'll put in our weekly signals. You see a signal here, is a buy signal here, 1,101. And we're just a little bit below that. So this is obviously, if we get out of this position, it's going to be a losing trade. But that's okay, because we've made some huge winners earlier on in this up move. I'm going to show you something else that you may not have seen. So I'm going to go to my weekly chart here. What I want to look at right now, I just put my drawing tool back on here. This is a, by the way, this is meant to show you and help you. Well, here's a crossover level. This is the, well, what we're looking at right now is the MACD indicator. If you've watched my videos before, you know we've talked about this market. This indicator was developed by a friend of mine, Gerald Appel, who I did several speaking tours with, both in Europe and Asia. So here we have a signal where the market just turns up right here, which is right around very close to where our weekly turned around. And it basically stayed intact for all of this time. It's getting very, very close, very, very close to turning down. Now, if we turn down this indicator, this will be the first signal we have seen since March. So there you have it, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, a substantial amount of time. So you want to pay close attention if this in fact happens. So that's one thing we're looking at. The other thing, I gave you the level on the weekly trade triangle. If that gets broken, then we want to be out of the market. And this, again, this is something where you really want to pay attention to these technicals, because the market has become more and more technically driven in the last several years. So again, you can see our trade triangles. You can see, I had to put our monthly ones in, but I know we got long right around this level here on our monthlies, and we're still long on the longer term. You can see here 888.70. We've talked about this before. We've got our Weekly is still positive from 1,101, and our short-term daily is actually negative. So if you're a longer-term trader, intermediate trader, you're only going to pay attention to these two right here. The daily one you're not going to be that interested in. And if you're a super long trader, you're only going to be trading this top one. So again, you've got three ways to trade it depending on your trading personality, the way we recommend trading with our trade triangles in equities and in indexes is to use the monthly, I'll write this down again so we all know, monthly for trend and the weekly for timing. That's getting in and out of the market. So there you have it. Let's see how things work out. Watch that level very closely. Adam Hewison from Market Club. Thanks for stopping by and every success in the market.